You've likely heard of the Mitchell Corn Palace, but how about a straw bale built museum? Head to a small town in Minor County and you'll find just that. In tonight's Eye on Keloland, Kelly Volk takes you inside the unique building that founders say carries a special message for future generations.
History lives here at the Campbell Straw Bale Built Museum in Carthage.
We wanted to preserve what we have, wanted to have a place for people to bring their things so they would be preserved for the future.
Barbara Molden is one of the founders who helped launch this project more than two decades ago. It was built entirely by volunteers. Pete Miller, a founder and a past president of the museum, says it opened in 2004.
I always said that this is a building that shouldn't have been, because it was built by people that had no building experience. We had no money. We had $200 in the bank when we started. So things just came our way for some unknown reason. We had grants there we tried for, and we had donations.
From school memorabilia to military uniforms to a movie script, this museum showcases local, state, and even some national history.
We have newspapers of President Lincoln being killed. We have all the newspapers in Carthage. We preserve people's birthdays, their life, their death, the happenings going on, the fires that happen in town, just to know how hard it is to survive, so people can learn that things aren't always easy, and if they're easy, they're not worth having.
The museum is also shining a light on agriculture.
There's people who come here that have no idea what the farmers raise or how it affects their lives. And that has a lot to do with what we save here.
Our family recipes.
Local business owner Melanie Hamilton's late mother, Henry True, is remembered through a display at the museum.
This is my mother. She was known as the pickle lady in town. I think at 83, she built her commercial kitchen.
But people don't just come here for the history. The building itself is a draw.
When people think straw bale built museum, where's the straw bales? In that they come outside, walk around, they see the stucco.
But these truth windows located throughout the museum offer partial views of the 1,300 straw bales in the building.
The walls are solid straw bales. They are the insulation. They are the walls. The timbers are only the framework to help hold the straw in place.
Local farmers provided the straw. Wood used for the museum comes from other buildings, including a dairy barn from the early 1900s. Molden hopes this museum, highlighting the past, helps guide future generations.
I've always loved history. And if we lose our history, how are our young people going to know how to take care of things in the future? They need to know where they come from and how they got here.
And some of those answers are here, inside this home for history. With Eye on Keloland, I'm Kelly Volk.
Now, the museum has struggled because of the pandemic. It will be open on the weekends from Memorial Day through Labor Day, but you can visit the museum year-round if you call ahead. We've included the phone number in this story on Keloland.com.